Hello, my name is Eric. I am an engineer here at Kemtrak. Today I am going to show you how to measure water in kerosene in a lab setting. For inline measurement, a turbid flow rate with a high velocity is required to disperse the water in the kerosene. Typically, a turbulent flow greater than 1.5 meters per second should be sufficient. For safety reasons, we do not have the possibility to pump flammable liquids in our laboratory, so I will demonstrate a technique whereby we use the energy from shaking and an ultrasonic bath to temporarily disperse the water in the kerosene. Firstly, I prepare 4 samples with 15 milliliters kerosene in each vial. I put the water in the sample using a micropipette. You can see the water sticking to the inside wall and not dissolving. I shake to disperse and measure the turbidity. It is clear that the value goes to zero almost instantly. If you shake, there is not enough energy to disperse the water and it sticks to the glass walls. So I put the samples in the ultrasonic bath. The ultrasonic waves will disperse the water in the kerosene. I leave the samples in the bath for 5 minutes, shaking intermittently, to be sure no water sticks to the glass. The water is now dispersed in the kerosene for some time. I now measure the samples. Measure as soon as possible, because the water will eventually separate from the kerosene. This is the result of our measurements. We can see the relationship between turbidity and parts per million. Notice that the curve isn't linear. Trying to mix two substances that dislike each other is quite a challenge. Any suspension of water in kerosene will be highly unstable. Due to the forces between the two liquids, the water will soon separate, forming larger droplets that will eventually cling to the glass walls of the container. This will be seen and measured as a decrease in the turbidity of the sample. With such samples, it can be difficult to correlate lab and process values depending upon the sampling, so care and thought need to be taken here. So long as the method used to prepare the sample is consistent, the results will be reproducible. I hope this video was informative, and I see you back here for the next Kemtrak episode. Don't forget to leave comments and click the subscribe button to receive notifications for new videos on our products.